leading by their biggest margin, a 5-point lead, 12-7, with 1:45 left to go in the first quarter. Down over the middle in the forecourt comes Perry for the Hearts. Pass off to Tien. He shoots up in the deep corner. Swish! Petey Tien drops in a pretty one from the far side, and the Hearts now have doubled the Caner Tech score. And it could be the Hearts are starting to untrack a little bit now, Allie. But Caner's got a lot of, they're a courageous young ball club, and they say they're young. They are young, no question about that. With two sophomores, a freshman, and two juniors as a starting five. There's a push up the side missed by Caner, and the rebound picked up by Ozzie Majel for the Hearts. He pass off to Petey Tien. Tien brings it down into the forecourt, pass off to Anthony Perry on their midcourt. Over the far side it goes to Glenn, in close underneath to Majel. He loses the ball, picked up by Caner. Fast breaking Riddick goes all the way in, shoots it up and misses. Riddick has missed at least three layup shots, mostly on the fly. He was fouled on that. Somerville High School in Boston, in Massachusetts, and at Holy Cross College. At the free throw line, Doug Riddick shooting it up and good. Riddick, a 5'8 sophomore. Stallings, the other guard, a 5'8 sophomore. Freeman, the 6'3" freshman. Second shot is good. And the Panthers. Caner's gone into a half-court press now. Hearts get the ball in the forecourt. They haven't had too much trouble with the press. Sure. Shot by Perry from the outside. Missed. Rebound picked up. A lead pass down court to Lovett. He just dunks the ball. 14-11. Caner Tech team is not to be taken lightly. They're pressing, and they're really pressing out there, trying to see if they can upset the Hearts and change the momentum of this ball game. Danny DuPont is in the ball game now for the Hearts, together with Dave Franks. On the midcourt, closely guarded is Anthony Perry. Passes off to Pete Tien. Back over this side, it comes to Perry. In the corner on the near side to DuPont. DuPont's pass deflected. Knocked out of bounds. Touch last by DuPont. That's five turnovers for the Hearts in this first quarter. Coach Eddie Generali is not too happy about that. The Hearts lead by three, but it's a slender three-point lead the way this ball game is going. In the forecourt, shot on the outside by Stallings is missed. Rebound picked up by DuPont as the buzzer sounds. Score at the end of the
line is they converted on 7 out of 10 free throws. That kept them in the ball game, but 2 out of 11, that's incredibly bad shooting by the Panthers. And they were 1 for 10 from the floor. The Hearts were 6 of 16.
Okay, and neither team shooting outstandingly well, but we have a hunch it's going to pick up. The shooting percentage is going to pick up. In the forecourt, Pete Tien shot from the outside of the foul circle. Good. So the Hearts start off the second quarter with a 1-for-1. In the forecourt come the Panthers. Lovett driving in, banks it up. Good. And let's see if the basket will not count. Evidently, the charge foul is going to be called against Lovett. The basket will not count. That, of course, is a tough break for the Panthers because they need everything they can get to stay in a close contention with the Hearts. Pass stolen by the Panthers in the forecourt, driving in, laying it up and missing is Stallings, and there's a foul call underneath in the battle for the rebound. Foul is called against Henry Brown. That's his third. So Brown may not be seeing too much action. He's picked up his three personals very quickly here in the opening minute of the second quarter. At the free throw line, Marv Stenson. Stenson is only a 5'4" He's the only senior. Dave Franks has come back into the ball game for the Hearts, replacing Brown. Stenson's shot is up and missed. Rebound is up and no good. And finally, the rebound is knocked out of bounds by Caner. Caner, in all fairness to the Panthers, they missed an awful lot of shots up in close. Of course, that might be nervousness on the part of the Panthers. But they've been making an exciting ball game out of it so far. They've been moving around well. In the forecourt with the ball, Calvin Glenn passes off to Franks. Franks shoots it up, misses. Rebound is picked up by Glenn. He shoots it up, misses. And the rebound picked up by Caner. Lead pass down court to Stallings, who made a beautiful going away over the head bank shot, layup shot that puts the Panthers back to within three. in the forecourt with the ball. Anthony Perry for Sacred Heart. Heart's leading by three, 16-13. Near side, Perry closely guarded. Passes off to Franks. Over the side, it comes to Glenn in the corner. Cross court over the far side to Pete Tien, and Tien is fouled by Stallings. What a sensational basket that Stallings made. Oh, that was a pretty one. I don't know how far this Cantor Tech team is going to go this year, but I'll wager a farthing or two that next year Cantor is going to be heard from. They have the makings of an outstanding ball club. Not too much height, but a lot of speed. Shot to the far line by Tien is good. Tien will get another. Hart's lead by four, 17-13. Second shot is good again. So Tien pops in two from the free throw line, gives the Hearts a 5-point lead. Lead pass down court is deflected out of bounds by Anthony Perry. It'll still be Kaner's ball, out of bounds behind their own hoop. The Panthers shooting at the basket to our right here in the... He shoots up in the deep corner, misses, rebounded by Richie Green. Green passes off, the ball is deflected out of bounds and touched last off of Perry's knee. Stenson. Gets it down over the middle in the forecourt. Now he's picked up defensively by Perry. Passes over this side. The ball's deflected, stolen by Glenn. Glenn to Perry. Perry lays it up. No good. There's a foul. Called against Basalin. Anthony Perry will go to the free throw line to take a pair. Perry has 8 points in the ball game. Craig Woods coming into the game for the Hearts, replacing Peach. Perry has a chance to add to that now. Shot is up and missed. Don't forget, at halftime, our halftime ceremonies today will feature the first annual Hall of Fame induction ceremonies by Sacred Heart. Second shot is good by Perry. 19-13. Hearts lead by six with 6 minutes left to go in the first half. Long pass down court is thrown away by Witz. We see big Donnie Sasso. There's a pass and a drive in. And let's see. Sacred Heart player. Who was that? Calvin Glenn. Flipped. And went down on the floor in a heap. He was fouled, I believe. Shot the foul line is up and good. Ebby Conlin is here tonight. Ebby has been following the Hearts quite religiously all season long. Ebby still got the Hearts' interest at heart, I should say. Second shot is missed. Follow-up shot is missed. And the rebound is up and missed by Glenn. And the rebound is up and missed again by Richie Green. He's fouled. Hearts' lead is up to 7 out, 20-13. Perry is 6 feet. Shot in the foul line is up and good by Richie Green. Green is 6'1". Calvin Glenn is 6'2". The only player over 6 feet for Kaner is their center, Rufus Freeman. Second shot is good. Hearts lead now 22-13. The ball kicked out of bounds to the far side by Sacred Heart as Kaner Tech try to move it up over the midcourt mark quickly. Hearts are pressing full court. Pass comes in to... Stenson's pass is off to number 13, Almeida. He lays it up and over the rim for a two-pointer. Makes it a 22-13 ball game. Hearts lead by nine. In the forecourt, Rich Green with the ball. Passes out in the midcourt to Craig Woods. Woods on the near side to Anthony Perry. Over the side, it comes in the corner to Glenn. Glenn's pass deflected, stolen. Picked up by Stenson. He drives all the way in, shoots it up, and good. Stenson... only 5'4", but extremely quick. As we mentioned before, he's the only senior on this Cantor Tech squad. In the forecourt come the Hearts. Wood over the far side to Rich Green. Green to Perry. Perry, a short one-hander up and good. Perry has 11 points to lead all scorers in tonight's ball game. With the ball, love it. Down over the middle in the forecourt, pass it off to Riddick. Riddick underneath, pass is stolen by Anthony Perry. Hearts lead by 7, 24-17. 4:40 left to go in the first half. Perry brings the ball down. Pass off to Calvin Glenn at the side. Glenn sets, shoots it up. No good. There's a foul call underneath against Dave, 11-inch sophomore. Shot is up and missed. The rebound is speared by Calvin Glenn for the Hearts. Pass off to Pete Tien, who's back in the ballgame. Tien shoots it up in the foul line. No good. A follow-up shot is missed by Majel, and there's a foul. Foul is called against Almeida. That's his second at the free throw line. Ozzie Majel, 6'2" junior, will take a pair. Shot is up and off the side. No good. Second shot by Majel is good. 25-17 the score. With the ball, Stinson gets it down over the middle in the forecourt. Passes off to Lovett. Lovett turns, shoots it up, misses the rebound. Picked up by the Hearts, Ozzie Majel. He, in turn, passes off to Anthony Perry. Perry still in the backcourt. Looks around, passes cross-court to Majel in the forecourt. Majel looks around, pass off to Perry. Perry down the middle, lays it up over the rim, and good. He makes it look easy. 27-17. A pass in, a steal by Calvin Glenn, lays it up and in. And the Hearts now very quickly have opened up a 12-point gap, 29-17. In the forecourt, driving in, laying it up and missing is Riddick. The ball knocked themselves. Canada Tech, however, is a very stubborn little ball club and very speedy. You know, they get the fast break on you. They can hurt you. Over this side, the pass to Lovett, turn, shoots it up, no good. The rebound picked up by DuPont for the Hearts. Kaner's shooting percentage must be very, very low here in the first half. Allie will tell you about that. In fourth court come the Hearts. Ball stolen and restolen by the Hearts. Danny DuPont goes in, lays it up, misses. A rebound by Majel. He has the ball knocked out of his hands. Rolling loose. Lead pass down court comes to Riddick. He goes in, lays it up, no good. As a charge foul called against Riddick on the play. Passes into Anthony Perry. 29-17, Hearts by 12. 3 minutes and 4 seconds left to go on the first half. In the forecourt with the ball, Anthony Perry on the near side. Passes off in the corner to DuPont. Now to Majel. Majel over the far side to Rich Green, and Green looks around. Passes over the far side to PT, and out in the midcourt it comes now to Perry. Perry over this side, into the corner to DuPont. DuPont to Majel. Majel has the ball knocked out of his hands, rolling loose, and it's picked up underneath by Majel. Majel turns, shoots up, shot is partially blocked. Follow-up shot is good by Richie Green. He was fouled. Carl Lovett. That is his third. Shot is up and missed by Green. The rebound is picked up by Freeman. Rufus Freeman of the Canada Tech team. Passes off in the forecourt to Riddick. Now to Stenson. Deep on the midcourt. Stenson looking around. 2:19 left to go in the first half. Hearts lead 31-17. Passes to Lovett. Lovett drives in, shoots it up. Coming into the ball game now for Sacred Heart, number 41, Paul Yates. Shot the foul line is good. Lovett will get another. Lovett's been averaging 20 points per game for the Panthers. How many has he got tonight, Allie? 6 points. That's a little bit below his average. Now he has 7. Well, of course, there's still 2 minutes left to go in the first half. 31-19 the score. Hearts lead. In the forecourt, Pete Tien passes cross-court over this side to DuPont. DuPont to Majel over the far side of Tien, driving the baseline underneath. Lays it up and good. 33-19. 9 points for Petey Tien in tonight's ballgame. Hearts enjoying a 14-point bulge here with a minute 45 left to go to intermission time. In the forecourt at the far side, Lovett with the ball. Closely guarded. He's got two men patrolling him very closely. Passes back out to Stenson. Stenson shoots it up from the inside of the foul lane. No good. Rebound underneath is up and no good by Rufus Freeman. the only really tall player on the Kaner Tech team at 6'3", but he is only a freshman. He drops in his first foul try. And Roof will get another. Second shot is missed. The rebound is batted out toward midcourt, picked up by Stenson. Stenson with the ball outside the foul circle. Passes off in the corner on the near side. The ball is knocked out of bounds to Stenson. Back to Riddick. In the corner comes to Freeman. High arcing shot by Freeman is missed. Rebound picked up by Calvin Glenn. Glenn in the backcourt to Yates. Yates still in the backcourt. Now gets it down over the middle. Passes off to Ozzie Majel in the forecourt. Back on the midcourt, it goes to Tien. Over this side, it comes to DuPont. DuPont to Majel. Shoots it up, misses. Rebound picked up by Kaner. Stenson driving in the forecourt. Kicks the ball. And it's rolling loose. Picked up by Freeman. Freeman passes off to Alameda. Alameda into Freeman. Freeman's short jump shot is good. 33-22. Hart's lead now is chopped down to 11. 33 seconds left to go on the first half. In the forecourt corner on the near side, Danny DuPont with the ball, pass out to Tien. Back to DuPont on the near side corner. Underneath it goes to Glenn. He lays it up and misses. Rebound underneath is picked up by Glenn. He shoots it up, misses again. Rebound is Freeman will get a 1-1. Shot is up and good. Freeman has 5 points. His bonus try is up and no good. The rebound underneath picked up by Calvin Glenn for the Hearts. 33.
Here. And what more fitting tribute than to a player who we feel was certainly one of the most outstanding ball players ever to come out of the city of Waterbury. Also, Billy Finn averaged 22.5 points per game in his senior year at Sacred Heart. And that total includes an incredible 52 points, which was scored against Naugatuck High in a game which was played down at the State Armory. And of course, Billy Finn was my backcourt mate at Sacred Heart when we played there. And I remember that game very, very well against Naugatuck. And that record still stands as the Naugatuck High School, or the Naugatuck Valley League, single game scoring record. And it's been challenged many times, but the record has maintained itself at 52 points. Certainly an incredible game, and I can remember some of the shots that Billy threw in that night just from all over the State Armory floor. What a phenomenal performance by Billy Finn. And basketball, if you can say basketball was anyone's life, it certainly was the life of Billy Finn ever since I can remember Billy. And we go back, we went back to the time when Billy was about 7 or 8 years old. We started playing together, and he certainly lived for the game. It was his whole life. And unfortunately, as we mentioned, that life tragically ended at the age of 19 for Billy Finn. Right now, the buzzer is sounded in the background, and we are getting set for the halftime ceremonies to be held here as both teams go over to their respective benches. Right now, we're going to turn it over to Glenn Culligan for a message from one of our sponsors.
Principal of Sacred Heart is on the microphone, on the floor microphone, that is, and he is speaking to the assembled fans here. And he has just introduced Father James Coleman, who is the principal of Sacred Heart High School. And now Father Coleman has just introduced former Sacred Heart coach Ebby Conlon. Former coach Ebby Conlon is stating that he is quite happy to present the first plaque to Dr. Allie Finn, who is a practicing physician in Torrington. And Ebby has just made the presentation to Allie Finn. And the cameras are flashing. Now, Dr. Finn, seems strange to be calling him Dr. Finn. I broadcast games that Allie played many, many, many years ago when Glenn Culligan was just a baby. Allie Finn has made his acknowledging statement, and The good doctor walks back to courtside. And Father Coleman, principal at Sacred Heart. Father Coleman is introducing the other half of the WATR sports broadcasting team, Allie Vestro, out on the courtside. I know Allie is quite touched by making this presentation himself. He and Billy Finn were very, very close. And not only teammates, but very good friends. And if I know Allie, he is getting quite sentimental out there as he's making this presentation. And now Allie is making the presentation. Well, Allie Vestro is making the presentation to Allie Finn. And Allie Finn is accepting on behalf of his deceased brother, Billy Finn. And Allie Finn has accepted the second plaque and made the acknowledgement on the PA system here at the Kennedy Gym. Father Coleman again introduces Ebby Conlon. Ebby Conlon will Ebby Conlon, I believe, is going to make the presentation to Ray Evans, who played also for the Conlon-coached basketball teams out at Sacred Heart High School. Ray Evans, also known as Red Evans. Very congenial young man. I don't think I've ever seen Red Evans when he didn't have a smile on his face. Evans has accepted the trophy from Ebby Conlon, and now he is making his acknowledgement speech. Notice Bernie Pogajenski here tonight, former Sacred Heart player. Also, Billy Scanlon, Franny Granato, Sacred Heart High football coach, is here. I'm trying to pick out, jog my memory, to see if I can recognize. Ray O'Toole is here tonight also. And some of the faces, some of the young men, they changed through the years. Father Coleman is introducing Big Donnie Sasso. 6 feet, 8 inches tall. I believe Donnie Sasso is now assistant principal or vice principal at South Catholic High School. I had the pleasure of having Don Sasso play for my baseball teams in the summer leagues for several years, and man, could he hit a baseball a country mile. And he certainly gave us a lot of thrills when he played for that Sacred Heart State Championship basketball team back in the 60s. He, along with Gary McKenna and Ned Cunningham and Butchie Azara. And right now, Donnie Sasso has made the presentation of the Hall of Fame trophy to Ned Cunningham, his teammate on that state title team. And that, I believe, will be the last Hall of Fame presentation for this evening and for this year. It's quite a fine thing that Sacred Heart has dreamed up to honor their past heroes of the Cage Wars. Ned has made his acknowledgement speech and thanks everybody. And now let's see what Father Coleman is going to say here. I believe that is the end of the presentation. The Hall of Fame ceremonies have been completed. Vice Principal of Sacred Heart, Dick Joseph, moves the PA microphone and its system back to courtside, and we're ready to go with more action the second half of tonight's ball game, which shows the Hearts leading Caner Tech 35-23. Here's Glenn Culligan with a message from our sponsor. There to go, the toss. The tap is picked up by the Hearts in the forecourt. A pass to Rich Green goes in, lays it up off the side, no good. Rebound by Henry Brown is good. So the Hearts start things off on the right foot, or might have been on the left foot. Henry Brown made the basket, I don't know, but they get 2 points up on the scoreboard to go ahead by 14, 37-23. In the forecourt with the ball now come the Caner Tech Panthers. They got their work cut out for them, Caner Tech has. In the forecourt, shot by Lovett from the deep corners, missed. Gets his own rebound, goes in, hooks it up from underneath, misses the rebound, picked up by the Hearts. Lead pass to Tien. In the forecourt, it goes to Brown. Brown sets, shoots it up, in and out. Rebound is batted around, picked up by Riddick. Riddick fast breaking, down over the middle, in the forecourt, over the hand, layup, and good. Beautiful move by Doug Riddick as he laid it up over the rim and dropped it through for the Caner Tech two-pointer. So each team has picked up a hoop here in the third quarter to start off action. In the forecourt, Pete Tien passes off to Rich Green. He goes in with a short layup, good. And the Hearts come back with a two-pointer to make it 39-25. So neither of the two ball clubs showing any case of jitters or nervousness starting off the second half here. Kaner looking very cool and loose out there. Stallings with the ball. Deep on the midcourt. Passes over this side to Bazalin. Cross-court it goes over the far side to Riddick. To Stallings. Stallings jump shot in the far line. No good. Rebound. Picked up by the Hearts. Calvin Glenn. Glenn to Anthony Perry. Perry at 13 points in the first half, leading all scorers. Pass underneath, deflected out of bounds. Underneath the Hearts hoop, deflected out of bounds. You're tuned to 13-20 game from the Crosby Gym. Broadcast time 10 of 8. Shot in the corner, missed by the Hearts. Rebound knocked out of bounds by Kaner. The game from the Kennedy Gym here. Shot from the outside of the foul circle by Pete Tien. A real high arcer, and it dropped in. 41-25. And let's see, on Saturday night, next week, 1 week from tonight, Holy Cross and Sacred Heart at the Crosby Gym, the return engagement between those two ball clubs. That should be a honey. Ball missed, is lost by Kaner, and Anthony Perry wastes very little time getting the ball into the forecourt for the Hearts. Passes over the side in the corner to Rich Green. Now to Henry Brown, shoots it up, misses. Rebound picked up by Kaner. Lead pass into the forecourt to Riddick. Riddick driving in, lays it up over the rim, in and out, no good. Rebound batted around, picked up by Kaner, and there's a foul call. Behind the rim, they're shooting at the basket to our left here in the second half. Shot in the deep corner by Basalian is good. 41-27, Hearts lead by 14, and they go on the offensive now. Kaner with a one-man chaser down court in Stallings. Pass down court into the corner, knocked out of bounds. Touch last by Lovett, and it's awarded to Kaner. Pass off to Stallings, who brings it down over the middle in the forecourt. Flips over this side in the corner to Vasalin. Vasalin, he passed the ball, went right into the hands of Pete Tien. Tien in the forecourt to Perry. Perry's shot is blocked and knocked into the hands of Riddick, and the Caner Tech Panthers go on the offensive again. Riddick brings it down into the forecourt to Stallings. Stallings on the near side to Lovett. Lovett underneath to Freeman. Fallaway shot by Freeman is good. 41-29. Kaner trying very hard to stay in there and get into real close contention. Long pass on the near side corner. Cross-court pass. The Hearts deflected, and let's see what the call is. Was there foul? Name of the number of the player. Might have been Riddick. However, Sacred Heart was awarded the ball. Glenn gets the shot, shoots it up, misses. Henry Brown shoots it up, misses. The rebounds. Follow-up shot is good by Rich Green. That makes it a 43-29 ball game. Hearts by 14 again. 8 points for Richie Green in tonight's contest. Caner Tech with the ball. Stallings over this side to Lovett. He sets, shoots it up, hits the rim, bounds high in the air. Rebound underneath, picked up by Sacred Heart's Henry Brown. Brown, the tallest player on the court at 6'5", passes down court to Rich Green. He misses layup. Rebound is picked up by Perry. He shoots it up, misses. Rebound by Rich Green is up, missed. Rebound is tapped out near midcourt, picked up by Kaner. They got a 2-on-1. Driving in, laying it up is Stallings. And let's see if the basket counts. Stallings makes the basket. It will count, but he is charged with a personal offensive charge foul. By 12, 3.5 minutes left to go in the third quarter here at the Kennedy Gym. All the action coming away over WATR. Richie Green gets a pass, goes in, lays it up, and good. Nice pass from Henry Brown to Richie Green. Hearts lead by 14 again, 45 to 31. 10 points for Richie Green in tonight's ballgame. Vasilin, a long set shot in the deep corner, misses. Rebound picked up by Tien. Tien driving in the forecourt, all the way in, banks it up and in. Beautiful move by Pete Tien. Backcourt. Yeah. The way the ball game is going, I assume there is not too much doubt about the outcome. Sacred Heart starting to pick up some momentum here and looking more like the ball club that they, which has given them a 5-0 record so far this year. A long set shot in the far side corner by Vasilin is good. And that cuts the Hearts lead back down to 14, 47-33. 2.5 minutes left to go in the third quarter. In the fourth court come the Sacred Heart team. Cross court pass to Tien. He sets, shoots it up on the outside of the foul circle, misses. Rebound underneath, picked up by Kaner. Rolling loose on the floor, picked up by Perry. Perry with the ball, driving in, shoots it up on the fly. Good. Anthony Perry, an off-balance shot. Anthony Perry has 18 points, or 15 points now for Sacred Heart. Leading all scorers in tonight's ball game. Shot by Vasilin, it's missed in the corner. Rebound picked up by Green. Green to Tien. Tien driving in the forecourt. Shoots it up again on the fly. Misses. Rebound by Calvin Glenn is up and in. Hearts have hit the 51-point mark here now, with a minute 45 left to go in the third quarter. And they lead by 18, their biggest lead of the ball game. Vasilin pass into Freeman. He shoots it up from 6 feet out at the side. Drops it through. 51-35. Hearts have got a big ball game coming up next Wednesday with Wilby here at the Kennedy Gym. Layup shot missed. Another layup shot missed. Follow-up shot is good by Calvin Glenn for the Hearts. 53-35. 8 points for Glenn. Hearts could possibly wind up having four double-figure scores in this ball game. In the backcourt, ball is stolen by Hearts, re-stolen by Vasilin. And he passed off to Lovett, who lays it up and in. 9 points for, I should have said Lovett made that layup shot. 53-37 the score. Anthony Perry shoots up a 15-footer, good, from the side. 17 points for Perry. The Hearts go ahead by 18 again, 55-37. 34 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Vasilin, long set shot in the deep corner, the far side, missed. Rebound picked up by the Hearts. Lead pass down court to Tien. Pass, he throws a jump shot. It looked like he was going to pass. Follow-up shot by Henry Brown is good. 6 points for Henry Brown. Status, Brown is the tallest player on the court at 6'5". Here in this ball game. In the forecourt, Stallings with the ball down the middle, all the way down, lays it up over the rim. No good. Rebound picked up by Glenn. As the quarter getting underway, the tap is picked up by the Hearts. And in the ball game now is Paul Yates for the Hearts in the backcourt. Yates has the ball. Passes off to Dave Franks. Franks to Ozzie Majo. He shoots it up and misses. There's a foul called underneath. Kaner Tech will put the ball into play in the backcourt. Panthers trailing by 20. Come into tonight's ball game. Kaner had a record of 3 wins and 2 losses. And that's not bad for a team that has a starting five of 2 sophomores, a freshman, and 2 juniors. In the forecourt with the ball. Love it. Throws up a jump shot on the fly. Good. Nice shot by Darrell Lovett, and he now has hit for double figures, 11 points. He's been averaging 20 points a game, Lovett has. For Kaner, in the forecourt come the Hearts. Pete Tien closely got it, passes off to Franks. Back to Tien. Tien shoots one up from the foul lane, no good. Rebound underneath, picked up by Kaner. With the ball is Lovett, gets it down over the middle, all the way in, shoots it up on the fly, good. He let one go from behind the back of his head. How he ever got that one up to the hoop, I'll never know. Those shots are the ones that excite the crowd, though. They're what you call a sensational circus shots. Lovett now has 13 points. But the Hearts still lead by 16, 57 to 41. Cross-court pass over the far side. The pass goes by Rich Green out of bounds, and he's only 5'4", and the only senior on the squad. Stenson in the four-court corner. Passes stolen. Passes off to Lovett. Lovett's shot is short. Ball pulled out of the air by the Hearts. Paul Yates brings the ball down over the middle, gets it in the forecourt. 6 minutes, 5 seconds left to go on the ball game. The forecourt at the far side, Lovett to Yates. Over this side, it comes to Tien. He sets, shoots up a 20-footer. Swish. Head now by 59-41 score. In the forecourt on the near side with the ball, Almeida. Pass over the far side to Riddick. Riddick goes in underneath, has the shot blocked, and a foul called against DuPont. Here's Doug Riddick shooting it up, and he misses the first. He'll get another. Bert Singleton coming into the ballgame for Sacred Heart, replacing Pete Tien. Singleton is a 6-foot senior. Haven't seen much of him this year. Second shot is off the side. Rebound picked up by Ozzie Majel. And the Hearts will put the ball into play offensively. Down over the middle of the forecourt comes Paul Yates. Pass over this side in the corner to DuPont. And a turn of arms with crimson piping. In the forecourt, Kaner Stinson. Over this side to Lovett. Lovett passes cross court to Riddick. Riddick goes in with a short jumper. No good. Follow up is good by Lovett. That's his 15th point of the ball game. He was fouled on the Pentuck Vanity contest. However, it is an intra-city affair. We don't see too much of Kaner Tech throughout the season. At the foul line, the shot is up and good by Lovett, so he gets his 16th point. And he now has, he's given the cut the Sacred Heart lead down to 15. In the forecourt with the ball, DuPont. Passes off to Majel. Twisting jump shot by Majel is partially blocked. Loose ball rolling around on the floor. Picked up by Sacred Heart's Singleton, and he drops one in from 8 feet out. 61-44. In the forecourt, Kaner. Moving the ball around. It's blocked, knocked into the air. Picked up by, let's see, picked up pass into Yates. Coach Eddie Generali has got none of his starters in there now. There's a shot missed. Rebound, pass down court, all the way down to Riddick, who lays it up and in. 61-46. 9 points for Riddick in tonight's ball game. 4:10 left to go in the contest. In the forecourt, Danny DuPont passes the pass. Is going to go stolen by Stinson for Kaner. Stinson driving in, shoots it up. He is fouled. Stinson will take two. First shot is up and cleanly through. Stinson will get ready for his second try now. Second shot is up and good again. 61-48. Kaner is in the full court press. They're trying to take advantage of the situation with Sacred Heart JVs in there, more or less, or reserves, if you will. Driving all the way in, Singleton lays it up and good. A beautiful move by Bert Singleton. Went one way, faked the other, came up with a beautiful underhand bank layup. Always pretty to see. In the forecourt with the ball, Kaner Tech's a tap in is good by Freeman. Hearts lead 63-50. In the forecourt with the ball, Paul Yates driving in the forecourt, kicks it out of bounds. Going to be Kaner with Richie Green. In the forecourt come the Kaner Tech Panthers. Basalin with the ball, 15-foot jumper, good. Nice shot by Basalin. 6 points for Larry Basalin. Pass down court stolen by Stinson. Pass off underneath. His pass is stolen by Paul Yates of the Hearts. Yates to Glenn. In the forecourt, it comes to Green. Green at the side. Passes off underneath to Glenn. Glenn turns. Shoots up a short one. Up and good. 65-52. Hearts by 13. 10 points for Calvin Glenn in tonight's ballgame. There's a foul call against the Hearts. Riddick's first shot is up and good. Now Riddick has hit for double figures for Caner Tech. Doug Riddick, only a sophomore. Got to admire these Caner Tech Panthers. They're really a young team. Pretty scrappy in there. Second shot is missed. Rebound is tapped up and missed. Rebound is picked up and laid up and missed. And the rebound finally picked up by the Hearts. Calvin Glenn. 65-53. Caner trails by 12. Anthony Perry back in the ball game now for the Hearts. Pass off to Wood. And the fork of the ball is deflected and there's a foul called against Darryl Lovett, I believe, for holding. At the free throw line, the first shot by Glenn is good. 11 points for Calvin Glenn in tonight's game. Second shot is good again. 12 points for Glenn, and the Hearts go ahead by 14 again, 67-53. 2:24, that's all there is left to go in this ball game. Stenson over the side to Lovett. High arcing jump shot by Lovett is around the hoop and out. Score. Hearts leading by 14. Shot from the foul line is missed. And if the Hearts can hold on to any part of this lead, they will have wrapped up the violation call against the Hearts on that shot. So Freeman will get two tries all over again. Again, he misses short. This time there's no violation, so he'll have just one try coming. And he misses three in a row from the foul line. Is Rufus, and the rebound is picked up by the Hearts. 67-53, that's the score. Craig Woods in the forecourt with the ball. Pass off to Glenn. Over this side it comes to Singleton. Singleton shot is missed. Follow-up shot is missed by the Hearts. Rebound is picked up by Caner Tech. Long pass down court to Riddick. He goes in, lays it up, and good. 67-55. Hearts by 12. 12 points for Riddick in tonight's game for Caner Tech's Panthers. Cross-court pass over the far side to Craig Woods. Now to Calvin Glenn. He shoots it up and good from 15 feet out at the side. 14 points for Glenn. In the fourth quarter, long shot is up and missed by Caner. The rebound picked up by the Hearts' Glenn. Lead pass in the fourth court goes to Perry, and there's a foul call. Shot in the foul line is good by Perry. Perry's second shot is good. 19 points for Anthony Perry. He's got it when he needs it. In the forecourt, Stenson, the long over-the-head push shot missed. Rebound picked up by Tyson. Tyson to Stenson. He shoots it up again, and this time he drops it through. 71-57, 1 minute left to go in the ball game. In the ball game for the Hearts is Rich Capobianco. Pass off to Craig with over the far side to Danny DuPont. DuPont shoots up a long one from the corner, misses. The rebound underneath is up and missed by Singleton. Singleton's rebound is up and missed again. Rebound by DuPont is hooked up and missed. Partially blocked. Rebound picked up by Stenson, driving in, and he is fouled. Crosby Holy Cross game on Tuesday of next week from the Crosby gym. Shot in the foul line, missed. Rebound picked up by Caner. Follow-up shot is missed by Lovett. A rebound picked up by Franks. Lead pass down court, stolen by Tyson of Caner Tech. Tyson pass off to Mitchell. Over the far side it goes to Tyson. He drops it up and in. 71-59, that's the score. Hearts leading. Caner trying to make the score a little more respectable. Ball stolen by the Panthers. Stenson driving in, lays it up and good. 71-61, 5 seconds, 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. That's the buzzer. And the Hearts win it by a 10-point margin. Passing them along to you in just a few moments. Right now, we'd like to remind you that all of the action and the halftime ceremonies, Hall of Fame ceremonies in tonight's ballgame, were sent your way as a public service and with the best wishes of Colonial Bank. Colonial, serving your banking needs with more than 60 convenient offices throughout Connecticut. By Schmitz and Serafine's Hardware, Garden, and Power Equipment Center, 464 Chase Avenue. Schmitz and Serafine's, the store with a friendly know-how. By Cardella's Fine Jewelers, with stores at 73 South Main Street in downtown Waterbury and 384 Stilson Road, overlooking the Naugatuck Valley Mall. and by your friendly neighborhood pharmacies, Bunker Hill, Riley and Burns on Grove Street, and the Apothecary on the Green, W.H. Pickett Drug, 675 North Main, and St. Francis Medical Equipment Center, 666 Baldwin Street. Now, Allie has the final totals. Take it away, A.V. Jr.
Okay, A.V. Sr., and here's the way it went for the winning Sacred Heart team. Leading the way tonight, as he has done in past several ball games, Anthony Perry. Anthony, with 19 points in tonight's game, leading all scorers. And again, very fine floor game played by Anthony Perry. Following Perry, it was Pete Tian with 15 points. We had Calvin Glenn close behind with 14 points. Rich Green came through with 10 points tonight, so four double-figure scores for Sacred Heart. Henry Brown had six. We had Burt Singleton with four, and Ossie Majel had three to round out the Heart scoring. For Caner Tech, the high point maker was Darrell Lovett with 16. It was followed by Doug Riddick with 12. Rufus Freeman had 11. We had Marv Stinson with eight. Larry Basalin with 6 points. Bill Stallings had four, and Steve Almeida and Dave Tyson had 2 points apiece for the Caner Tech Panthers. From the foul line in tonight's ball game, Caner Tech was 15 out of 28. Sacred Heart, 13 out of 21. And from the floor in tonight's game, the Hearts hit on 29 out of 84 attempts. And in case you're interested in percentages, that comes to 34% for Sacred Heart. And the Caner Tech Panthers made good on 23 of, let's see, 59. Attempts, and percentage-wise, that comes out to 38%. Here's the way the scoring went by periods. Sacred Heart outscored Caner Tech in the first quarter, 14-11. And again in the second period, 21-12. Hearts led by 12 at halftime, 35-23. In the third period, Sacred Heart opened up the ball game, hitting for 22 points to Caner Tech's 14. The Hearts took a 20-point edge into the fourth quarter, 57-37. In that fourth period, Caner Tech outscored Sacred Heart. The only period they did, it by 10 points, 24-14. But it wasn't nearly enough for the Panthers, as Sacred Heart wins their sixth game in a row without a defeat this year, 71-61 over Caner Tech.
Okay, thank you very much, Allie. And that's about it from the Kennedy High School gym. An historic night as far as Sacred Heart is concerned, because they inaugurated their first Hall of Fame this evening. And we hope you were with us throughout the Hall of Fame ceremonies, and we hope you enjoyed the ceremonies together with the broadcast. Our next broadcast of Scholastic Basketball will be next Tuesday. We'll be at the Crosby Gym next Tuesday to bring you the Holy Cross Crosby game, broadcast time at 10 of 8. Until then, on behalf of the WATR sports crew, Allie Vestro and Glenn Culligan, this is Al Vestro wishing you all a very pleasant good night. Returning you now to our WATR studios and your musical host for the evening.
How are things up there at the Coalland?
What would you like to hear? How about if we wait until a couple of the players come
out? Yep,
that's not a good idea. You keep on talking, you're on. Oh, I'm on. And here's Thomas Jones, an alumnus back.
Is this on?
This is on, we're on.
All right.
Thomas, what do you think? You're going from Sacred Heart, but you're back here supporting the team and all. What do you think about the performance tonight?
Well, they look real good. They're learning well.
And now you're out in Rainy River Community College. Tell us a little something about rain. Does it rain a lot out there?
No, it snows. It's just cold.
It's a cold place. Thomas is paying the price out there, brother. And why don't you tell the fans how many points you're averaging out there, Thomas?
22.
22. I taught him well, huh? Taught him how to shoot. You going out of school, right, Father? Yeah. Yeah, we're short of game tape. Well, okay.
I made a job.
Good.
You want to get a play?
With us tonight, two of the workhorses in tonight's game, Oswaldo Majel and Calvin Glenn. Oz, what did you think about the game tonight?
Kind of rough for a second there. It's kind of rough.
Yeah, it got a little close at the end. You did a nice job, I thought, in the second period, taking a ball, breaking her half-court trap.
It was kind of hard, you know. It ain't easy every time.
Well, now, you came over from Crosby. What do you think about Sacred Heart over Crosby? You know what?
I'm glad I'm here. That's all I can say.
All right. We'll be glad to have you, Oz. And then we have Calvin Glenn. Calvin, we have you down for 23 rebounds tonight. Speechless.
No comment.
No comment. Well, what do you think about the next game against Wilby?
it's going to be tough, but we're going to win if we just play together and play team ball.
All right, that's spoken like a true veteran, Calvin. Nice job. And I know Henry Brown wants to get in here, so please, son, you're a little wet. And Rich Green, and we have Rich Green here.
Hi.
We have Rich. Rich, 14 rebounds tonight.
14, that's all.
14 rebounds.
Outstanding.
Very nice job. What do you think about the upcoming game against Wilby?
I think we're going to win.
We're going to win.
What do you think we have to stop? You saw Wilby last night. What do you think the story is there?
Marty here
is a big player. And there we have
Marty here.
Pete Tien. And Henry Brown. Henry, you have a big job.
His first 4 points of the year.
Of his career.
He might be 6'8", but it don't matter. Don't matter if he's 6'8", you're a clown. A clown.
Thank you.